This problem is about differential reactors, which are flow reactors that are used to measure the rate of reaction under conditions of differential conversion. And so this is a simple conceptual problem in which we have a reaction occurring and we're going to change the space-time. So the space-time is going to be doubled. And so we'll expect that the reactants will on average spend twice as long inside the reactor under these conditions of differential conversion. For a differential reactor, typically is a packed bed reactor. And so maybe before I write the balance, let's just say that we're talking about simple reaction of A reacting to produce B. And so we can write down the material balance, say, for the production of B. And if it's a packed bed reactor, we can do that with respect to W. All right, and that's equal to the rate of formation of B. And that can be a function of temperature and various concentrations, particularly the concentration of A, but it could be a function of the concentration of B and so forth. All right, and that function is to be determined by the experiments. All right, but this problem basically asks, okay, how will things change in this expression when we have a change in the space-time? And in the case of a differential reactor, which we're saying that we're maintaining the operation as differential, what that means is that none of these parameters that the rate depends on will change. We're operating it so that there is no real change in the reactor concentration as we go from inlet to outlet. So we achieve low conversion, we achieve a low temperature rise or decrease, etc. And so that basically means that the reaction rate, the rate of production of B, is equal to a constant, right? Because the conditions inside the reactor are not affected by how long stuff spins inside the reactor. And this, furthermore, we could actually stop right here and answer this problem, that the rate is equal to a constant. But if we want to take it a little bit further, then we can say that the amount of B that we end up producing will be a constant regardless of the space-time, again, if we maintain differential operation. All right, what will change but wasn't asked in this problem is the conversion. And so if you decrease the space-time but produce the same amount of B, you would really do that by changing your flow rate in of your reactant. And so then your fractional conversion of how much you produce divided by how much you fed will be affected. And you would expect that to be affected by a factor of 2 in this case. All right, but that, again, is not what the problem asks. It asks for the rate of reaction that's occurring in this reactor. And because the conditions inside that reactor volume are not affected by changing the space-time when the conversion is differential, then the rate is actually a constant.